Hi, I'm Erik Voss. And this Joaquin Phoenix Joker movie has released a surprising amount of footage, considering the movie just began shooting a couple weeks ago. Now, I already broke down the very first look we got of the Joker in another video. Now let's look at the new footage for all the details that you might have missed. And a customary spoiler warning in case any of these predictions end up being right and they'll ruin your life. Okay, let's start with this camera test released by a director, Todd Phillips, showing Joaquin Phoenix as the struggling 1980s comedian Arthur Fleck, becoming the Joker in his makeup. Let's take a look.
I should laugh, but I cry, because your love has passed me by. You took me by surprise. I didn't realize that you were laughing.
Jeez, can we please get a trigger warning when a clown's gonna flash on screen? Okay, now Todd Phillips called this a camera test, and typically movies do conduct these kind of screen tests very early in production, shooting some simple raw footage, showing an actor in the early stages of character development, to test out alternate options for their looks so they can see how it looks on screen. You may have actually seen camera tests included in bonus footage on Blu-ray releases, and it's almost never released to the public before a movie comes out because the character is still in its raw stages, and filmmakers don't want audiences to prematurely hate this movie. But that's what makes this Joker camera test so interesting. This is clearly more produced than just any raw footage. There's a ton of creative choices being made. Camera movement and flash projection upon Phoenix showing his Joker clown look, and it's also terrifying. And yeah, there's music. This song is called Laughing by the Guess Who. And if you watch all this closely, you can detect some subtle acting choices by Joaquin Phoenix. Like notice how one of his makeup eyebrows is a bit higher than the other. And he accentuates this with a little tick of his real eyebrow. It gives his character a mischievous confidence. Like he's in on a joke that we aren't. And it suggests that his self-applied makeup is an extension of his own personality. The implication here is that Joaquin Phoenix's Joker will be on a more grounded side of the spectrum, closer to Heath Ledger's Joker, who also applied his own makeup, instead of the Jack Nicholson or Jared Leto Jokers, whose Jokers followed the more classic origin of their skin being bleached in an Ace chemical vat. Meanwhile, the cleaner spread of Joker's makeup compared to Ledger's makes this Joker closer aesthetically to Cesar Romero's Joker from the 60s Batman TV series. And if this camera test teaser wasn't enough for you to form an opinion, we got even more footage and behind the scenes images that show Phoenix's Joker in a subway station. Take a look. Okay, there's actually a lot to break down here. First, notice how the Joker's makeup has been adjusted a bit from the test footage. That blue streak on the right eye has been extended downward, almost like a tear rolling down to his lips. Like, I know it's a little early to be reading into these details. I just like the idea that his makeup might include an alteration that depicts him in a more tragic light. Now, what exactly is going on in the scene? If you look closely at the background, you can see some other thugs in clown makeup, and one of them carries a sign reading, "Kill the Rich." Maybe part of the Joker's plan in this movie is to stoke some of those class divisions that Bane actually exploited in The Dark Knight Rises, to turn the lower classes of Gotham against the wealthy elite. And in this case, the clown costumes could be their way of identifying themselves as part of this protest. And looking back there, they're definitely beating somebody up. I'll get to that in a second, but first, this video is sponsored by ExpressVPN. So a VPN allows you to browse the internet with privacy, without entities like ad companies or hackers or spyware tracking your data. ExpressVPN masks your IP address to make sure you aren't being monitored. ExpressVPN is the fastest VPN on the market and the number one VPN service rated by TechRadar. And also, if you're in a different country, which is definitely something I've run into where suddenly I can't access my regular stuff on YouTube or Netflix, some of you guys have actually reached out saying that you can't access everything that we talk about here because of where you live, which is kind of crazy. ExpressVPN gives you the internet without restrictions. You can securely stream or download content from anywhere, anytime. It's less than $7 a month with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So take back your internet privacy today and find out how you can get 3 months free by clicking the link in the description box. ExpressVPN.com/newrockstars. That's ExpressVPN.com/newrockstars for 3 months free with a 1-year package. Okay, let's get back to this Joker footage. So this sucker that they're jumping could be a wealthy celebrity who rode the train. My theory is that this is Thomas Wayne. Looking at some of the other set photos, there's a political campaign poster revealing that Thomas Wayne will run for mayor in this movie. So maybe Batman's billionaire dad is taking the grimy Gotham train for a photo op. but it just goes very poorly. Or maybe this movie could be borrowing the plot point from the Nolan Batman movies, remember, which established Thomas Wayne as the engineer behind the city's train lines, who made sure to take this public transportation whenever he could, even when it meant dragging his wife and son through a crime-ridden neighborhood. Look, I'm all for erasing class divisions, but take a driver. But that's not the only Nolan Batman reference in this scene. You can see the Joker wearing a separate clown mask over his makeup, possibly to blend in with the other clowns. Heath Ledger's Joker, of course, pulled this move at the beginning of The Dark Knight, which itself was a nod to the Cesar Romero Joker in the 60s series. And on top of that, other set photos revealed this Gotham subway map, which is filled with a ton of Easter eggs for Chris Nolan, but also a ton of Batman references. Amusement Mile is a location in Gotham that I talked about in my last video. You can also see Nolan Lane, as well as Kane County for Bob Kane, the artist who co-created the Batman character. And some of the Kane County stops include Starlin Avenue and Englehart Boulevard, a nod to comic artists Jim Starlin and Steve Englehart, as well as Adams Drive, which could be for Adam West. There's also a Wayne Avenue, which I guess isn't too odd for the richest family in town to have a street named after them, but also Grant Field, possibly for Batman comic writer Alan Grant, McKean Island for Dave McKean, illustrator of the Arkham Asylum graphic novel, an area called Burnside, maybe for Harvey Dent Two-Face, a little too soon, and Prince Street, which I'm interpreting as a nod to Prince's music for the Tim Burton Batman movie. And you probably noticed an area called Snyder, which could be a nod to Zack Snyder or to the Batman comic writer Scott Snyder, and an area called Otisburg, which you'll probably remember as a reference to that joke in the Superman movie.
Otisburg? Who's Tess Mottrick? She's got her own place, man.
Otisburg?
It's a little bitty place.
Otisburg?
Okay, I just wipe it off. That's all. It's a little town.
How do you think Joaquin Phoenix's The Joker will compare to the other Jokers that we've seen? Heath Ledger, Jared Leto, Jack Nicholson, Cesar Romero, and of course Mark Hamill's vocal version for the animated series and movies. Comment down below with your thoughts and follow me on Twitter and Instagram at EAVoss. And for a more comical take on the DC Universe, come check out my superhero parody show, Infinity Fan, premiering this weekend in the LA area. If you come, you may get hit with a stray batarang. You know you want to be there.
Exactly.
Show details and ticket info are in the description below. And remember to subscribe to this channel for more videos where I get scared looking closely at clown videos. Hey, come on, guys!